Wonderless Yoga. Thank you so much for joining me today. We're in New York and we will be practicing our yoga in front of the Brooklyn Bridge. And it's really beautiful out here right now. Temperature is perfect. I'm super happy about that. I actually wanted to give you guys a little history of the Brooklyn Bridge. I did a little reading last night. I wasn't expecting to necessarily find anything interesting, and there's a bridge after all, but I was surprised. There's a lot of interesting things about the Brooklyn Bridge. I do encourage you to Google it yourself when you have time, or I might post a link for you guys to read, but I'm just gonna talk a little bit about some of the information that I found about the bridge. I'm gonna pan over to it while I tell you about it. So I wanted to tell you guys about who is the person responsible for this beautiful bridge that connects Manhattan to Brooklyn. An engineer by the name of John Roebling dreamed this bridge up in the 1850s. His goal was simply to create a safe passageway across the East River, and also overall just an easy commute for working class New Yorkers. So during the early stages, John was actually injured while working on the bridge and sadly passed away in 1869. So he did not get to see his dream come true. And that is super sad to me. He sure thought up something really beautiful. So in John's passing, his son stepped up, his son Washington Roebling. He stepped up as a chief engineer, and he was responsible for bringing this bridge to life. But like his father, he fell ill while working on the bridge. He did not pass away, but he was confined to bed rest for the rest of his life. So he was not able to bring this bridge to completion either. So who was responsible for completing this bridge? Washington's wife, Emily. So Emily took command of the project to its completion. She's actually the first person who crossed the bridge maybe about a week before its official opening, which was in May of 1883. So now Emily, she was fancy. She crossed this bridge while riding a carriage with a rooster in her lap. Why a rooster, you ask? Because roosters are a sign of good luck. So it started with Robert. Excuse me, it started with John. And then it went to his son, Washington. And then Washington's wife, Emily, was responsible for the completion of this bridge. Now, one other interesting thing that I will mention is that the Brooklyn Bridge actually held the record for being the longest suspension bridge in the world for 20 years until their next door neighbor, literally right next door, the Williamsburg Bridge, stole the title in 1903. So we got the Brooklyn Bridge, then we've got the Williamsburg Bridge. This is friendly competition at its finest, I guess. So that's just a little background about the Brooklyn Bridge. I wanted to give you guys a little history of the places we're gonna be visiting. I didn't do that while we were in Paris, mainly because that was my first video and I was really nervous. So there's a few things I forgot to do, but it's okay, I'm gonna redeem myself at the Eiffel Tower one day. I'm gonna redo that. That's on my to-do list. One day, no rush. But I hope you guys will enjoy today's video. Let's get started. So I realized after watching the first video that we pretty much just kind of hopped into it. And I didn't talk too much about poses. So today I actually want to go over the names of poses, just so you guys can start to be familiar with names. We're gonna start at a basic to moderate level, and as time passes we will get more into the difficult poses, but I want to start from the basic point from the beginning. So we are actually in our first pose, and that's just standing straight up. This is called mountain pose. This is pretty much the base for all standing poses. This is where you feel grounded to the earth and you pretty much
focus on your surroundings and your breathing, making sure your feet are sturdy. Proper breathing is what really helps you with the difficult poses and really just being in the moment, not being distracted by outside situations. So we're just going to go ahead and stand in mountain pose, and let's take 5 deep breaths. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Finish out for your 5 breaths. Now straight from here, we are going to step into our tree pose. So you have 4 different places where you can position your feet. The first place is right here at your ankle. The second place is right here at your calf. The third place is higher up on your thigh, or you can cross over your thigh. So the choice is yours, whatever feels comfortable. This is normally where I hang out, but my legs are a little slippery. So I'm gonna hang out right in here. So wherever you feel most comfortable with, your ankle, your calf, or your inner thigh. Now it's important to stay balanced and make sure your leg is staying straight. You don't wanna lean into your leg. You wanna keep it as straight as possible. You wanna push your hands heart center. And we're just gonna hold. Let's take 5 deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Finish out your 5 breaths. So right from our tree pose, we are going to get into an additional standing pose. We're going to take our 2 fingers, we're going to grab our big toe, and we're going to extend down. You're going to pull straight out. This is called extended hand big toe pose. This is challenging. If you're wobbling, it's okay. You guys might see me wobble. Obviously, we are getting a good stretch in our hamstrings. Let's hold for 5. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Try to stay as sturdy as possible. Finish out your breaths. All right, so we're finishing out. Now we are going to do our other side just for the sake of balance today. We're really focusing on learning the names of poses and what they're beneficial for, but we're gonna balance things out. So go ahead and find where you wanna be on your opposite side. Get your hands heart center. Let's breathe for 5. Hold your tree as sturdy as possible. And when you're ready, get yourself into that extended hand to big toe pose. 2 fingers. Grab that big toe. And we're going to extend out. Let's breathe for 5. Sturdy as possible. All right. Now from here, we are going to transition into triangle pose. So your feet should be spread apart approximately a leg's length in between. I'm gonna hang out right in here. Actually, a little bit more. So what you wanna do, we're gonna take our right hand and you can either hang out your thigh area, your the area, your shin area, all the way down to your ankle. With your other arm, we're going to just kind of extend straight up. Since you're trying, let's take 5 deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Bench out for 5 breaths. And let's go to our other side. So once again, you can hang out in your thigh area, your knee, your shin, or all the way down to your ankle, and just extend up to the sky. Let's breathe for 5. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Finish out for 5. So from here, we are going to go into our Warrior One poses. So we're gonna keep our left foot forward. We're gonna turn our right foot to the right. We're gonna turn our upper half to face our right foot. And we're gonna simply extend our arms up to the sky. This is your Warrior One pose. Let's take our moment to take our 5 breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. You should be taking deep breaths in and releasing it all out. Let's go ahead and turn our right foot forward, our left foot to the left. We're going to turn our body facing our left. Go ahead and raise your hands up to the sky. And let's take 5 deep breaths. To Warrior Two. So we're not going to change our legs, but we are going to change our upper half. We're going to look forward and extend our arms out to their sides. This is our Warrior Two pose. Let's breathe for 5. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Finish out your 5 breaths. Now let's go ahead and flip our feet back to the other direction. So your left foot forward, your right foot to your right. Bring our bodies straight forward and extend these arms back out. And let's take our 5 breaths in this direction. And this is our Warrior Two pose. Deep inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Show. So from here, we are gonna go into our Warrior 3 pose. How many warriors are there, right? All right, we're in our Warrior 3 pose. So I want you to turn to your right foot. Go ahead and lift that left foot up. And bend forward. You can keep your arms here, or you can go here. Whichever one is more comfortable for you. I think I'm gonna stay to the sides. Let's take our 5 deep breaths. All right, let's switch feet. So extend your left foot left. Turn to our left, lift that right foot up. And breathe for 5. If you're a little wobbly, join the club. My surface is very uneven, so I'm struggling a little bit today, guys. Doing my best though. Let's breathe for 5. Wobbling and all. Alright guys, so we can let our Warrior 3 down. And now we are going to get into plank pose. I'm sure you all are familiar. So this is one of those poses that you really want to have your breathing down packed, because the longer you can breathe properly and focus on that, the longer you'll be able to hold yourself. You are balancing your body based off your hands and your feet right now. So let's try to hold for 10 seconds. Inhale. Exhale. Not 10 seconds, 10 breaths. I know. Struggling a little, maybe. Hold on, we're almost done. Let's take 3 more breaths. Down slowly. Go ahead and extend those toes out. Now there's 2 different poses we're going to do here. Just by simply raising up this much, you're in a slight back bend and you are in your Cobra pose. This is great for working out those kinks, stress relief, pressure relief. Now extending all the way up, we are now in upward dog. Let's take 5 deep breaths while we are in a full back bend. Let's just go ahead and stretch it out. Inhale. Exhale. As we finish out our upward dog, we are going to go into downward dog. So flip these feet, lift our hips. I want you to walk forward just as much as you need to get your feet flat. Feet flat, hands flat. Hips to the sky. We are now in downward dog pose. We are elongating our cervical spine, stretching out those hamstrings. This is a great body stretch. This is great the first thing in the morning, upward and downward dog. It's great for the end of your day. Relieve some of that stress. You don't want to go to bed with it. Let's just get a good stretch right here. I'm sliding a little bit. Let's breathe for five. Finish out. So we're going to go ahead and finish out our downward dog. I did forget to mention, if this is challenging for you or your hamstrings, all you have to do is simply bend your knees in a little bit, just like that. So if you're comfortable to be straight up, awesome. If you're not, this is awesome. Whatever your body wants to do and feels comfortable with, that's where you need to be. One thing at a time. So let's go ahead and drop our knees. Flip your feet out and extend your back. We are now in child's pose. This is a great resting pose. Sometimes when I'm in practice and I'm working with some of my teachers that are challenging, to say the least, and I need a moment to myself, this is the pose I get into. This is how I get recentered. To either end my practice or step back into practicing those challenging poses. This is a great stretch for your back, your arms. Let's take 10 deep breaths here as we conclude our session for today. Inhale. This should all be teaching. I want you guys to learn about the different places that I visit today at the Brooklyn Bridge. And I also want you to learn the basics of yoga, A to Z. So I thank you guys so much for joining me today for another episode of Wanderlust Yoga. I hope that you will subscribe so you can travel with me as we explore the world and practice yoga. Don't forget to like and subscribe and have something nice. to say, feel free to comment. Positive vibes only over here. Namaste. The light in me always honors the light in you. Thank you so much for joining me today. See you next time.
There you go.